Since the global financial meltdown in 2008, the Elks Credit Union has put stringent measures in place to safeguard its members' deposits as the organization seeks to comply with stringent international financial regulations. As a result, the Elks administration has effected some changes. This includes conforming to the Anti-Money Laundering and Terrorism Financing Act, which calls for more documentation in the opening of customers' accounts. That involves a declaration of the source of funds above the $5,000 threshold. President of the union, Lennox Mondesi, urged the timely servicing of loans in keeping with the international requirements. But with a number of members who were attached to the hospitality industry displaced by COVID-19, the union is noticing a trend in which members are making more withdrawals than deposits, which is not good for them or the financial institution. At its 42nd annual general meeting, the union indicated that it may have to refinance loans or put moratoriums in place to help the displaced members, which leaves the organization with less disposable income.
Well, for this year, 2020, it has been a little rough because now we have to address some of the members' needs. Most of our members are from the hospitality industry. They are unemployed. So we have to make provisions for the loans, for servicing the loans, or refinancing or put moratoriums in place. And you can imagine the domino effect it will have. Then we'll have less money because of IFRS 9. We have to make provisions for these loans if they are going bad. So now you can imagine the circumstance that we have found ourselves in.
The credit union says when COVID-19 hit the island, in this regard, it has cooperated with the government in observing all COVID-19 protocols established by the Ministry of Health. At the meeting, officials took the opportunity to urge members to continue to purchase permanent shares from the credit union, which will allow it to mitigate against risk.
If your permanent share still stands at $100, you should purchase the minimum allowed, which is $300. So you have to add $200 to it. Only then you can engage in all services offered to the membership. In that regard, I implore you to bail our capital base with the required $300 permanent share for membership in the credit union.
The board of directors committed to monitoring the fiscal situation of the organization very closely to take the necessary measures to ensure the survival of the credit union. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.